Joining us, we have James Carafano. D.R. Barton is with us. Lawrence Jones, right next to me, and Susan Lee and Ashley Webster. Carafano, to you first, if I may. I'm expecting a highly contentious news conference. And you?
I don't know. I feel like I'm sitting at the Thrilla in Manila, you know, waiting for. But look, the president's, I think, actually been very, very disciplined and focused on this trip, on the key issues, on Brexit, on the trade deal, and on the big foreign policy issues, you know, particularly Iran and China. And I think he's going to come through for us and really hammer that home here.
Okay. Lawrence, you're with me. You're sitting right next to me. Be careful what you're saying.
Right.
What do you got to say about the impending Thrilla in Manila?
Well, I believe that the president is going to be measured, but there's also, you know, when it comes to the president, because of the protests that have been in London, don't expect the president to shy away from his positions in there because of that relationship that has been antagonizing the president. When it comes to Theresa May, don't expect as much respect for her because she's a lame duck. He'll probably give her a little praise and then move on to what his position is when it comes to Brexit.
It's going to be good stuff, isn't
it? It's going to be good TV.
However, I want to talk to Ashley for a moment about these demonstrations.
Yeah.
They were supposed to be huge.
Well, they were talking about 250,000. I saw 10 to 12,000 from Trafalgar Square. It's been a lousy day. It's been pouring with rain. And this is a kind of a group of groups put together loosely, anti-nuke, climate change, anti-Trump, you name it, all together moving. They've been shuffled away from Parliament. The president will be able to hear them. There's been very relatively peaceful. There was a small scuffle, and there you can see Mr. Trump and Mrs. May heading to the press conference.